Hello Librans, welcome to my channel Surbhi, and this is the reading for you for the coming half of January. And before proceeding to the reading, Happy New Year to all of you. Wish you all the luck, happiness and abundance in the coming year, and stay blessed. Coming to the reading, awesome reading Librans for you. I think best of what I have done till now for January. And out of the six cards over here, you have five major arcanas. So whatever is happening is happening for good, is happening, is destined to happen, and is happening fast, okay, and is good for you, and is good for you, okay. So there should not be any hitch in accepting this change, whatever this change is coming up, okay Librans. So the first major arcana is the Lovers. So with the Lovers, obviously, as the name implies, though it can be trying to balance the situation between you and your partner or your loved one, it can be that. But seeing the other cards, I think you, this is a romantic reading. Perhaps this is the romantic reading, I guess. But definitely, it has to be some sort of a balance which has to be achieved either in your mind or actually in a relationship. I am saying mind, because we have the Temperance card also, which is all about balancing. So I think you are trying to balance something. You are definitely trying to balance something. See, I don't know why I am getting. Now there's the Chariot is also there. Though it is a very fast moving energy, all of them are major arcanas. So here it is also about balancing the black and the white. This is also about balancing, and this is also about balancing. But what I am feeling over here is, you are trying to balance a romantic situation or a relationship with a partner. You are trying to balance a relationship. That's what I am trying to say basically. And it seems to be obviously a romantic relationship. You are trying to, either you have two options. You are trying to take a decision. If for those of you who are not involved in any romantic relationship, suppose it is a marriage situation, you are trying to balance the marriage situation. If it is your loved one, then you are trying to balance that. Perhaps I am not getting that options type of a thing. What I am feeling over here, you are trying to balance a situation, and I think you have nearly balanced it. You have balanced the situation because we have the Chariot, which means moving forward, and it is a very fast moving energy. Chariot is a very fast moving energy, and it takes up very fast. So I am saying that I think you have come to a conclusion. You have taken a decision, and Librans, it is a very tough thing for you to take a decision. Though people say that the Librans are the scales going up and down, and it is a very balanced sign, it's all bullshit. They are not at all a balanced sign. They take a hard time achieving that sort of a balance. And after that balance is achieved, again, they are always weighing those pros and cons. According to me, it is an indecisive sign of indecisiveness. Okay, because they are taking so long to achieve that balance that most of the time is gone in indecisiveness or a lack of decision making. Okay, so too much of pros and cons. See, I am saying that you have come to a decision, you have balanced the situation in your mind or in actuality, whatever it is, because the things are moving forward with the Chariot. You have the Star card, so whatever this balance you have achieved, this is the right decision, because with the Star card, you have all the happiness for you around. Whatever this rebalance is, once you achieve this balance, once you start moving the things forward, once you act on this, okay, just see. Now, this is the balance in the relationship which you are trying to achieve. Obviously, it is a relationship. You are trying to achieve a balance. It is a divine connection or a soulmate connection, and it is divinely connected. You cannot get out of it, Librans. It is something from the heaven. This connection, whatever this connection is something from the heaven. You are trying to balance this situation somehow, or you are trying to come to a decision somehow. You have taken a decision nearly, and you are now ready to put this into action. Rather, you are advised to put it into action, because this relationship, once you take a decision and act on it, this is going to give you a lot of happiness. And with the World card, it is definitely going to open vistas of a new world for you. Okay, it is definitely going to be a new beginning for you. It will be perhaps whatever your life was happening till now will be totally changed. will be totally changed to the, in the sense that you will be very happy with this relationship. Okay, it is, suppose you were sad till now, it is ending of that chapter and opening of a happy chapter, sort of a thing what I'm trying to say. Obviously it won't be that you have been totally unhappy throughout life. There must have been some sort of happiness, but what I'm trying to say is this world card is, it's coming round. Things are coming to an end. Maybe whatever decision you were taking, you have taken pretty long time to take a decision, and now that indecisiveness is coming to an end. And now since you have decided to act on it, or you are advised to act on it, you will be able to open a new way to your happiness, and you will be very happy and content with this. And with the Eight of Pentacles, perhaps you've been working very hard on this relationship, and then you have achieved it, or you will achieve it if you act on it. Or it can be the other way around, that throughout life you have been in this energy that you are just working, focusing on your pentacles, focusing on your goals, just trying to build up the life, materialistic. It is all about materialistic things. There is nothing emotional in it. So perhaps whatever life you have led till now was too focused on your work, was too focused on your building up foundations, which are all materialistic, and you were all alone. And you were working all alone, day and night you have worked on these pentacles, you have really built up a very strong foundation, you have really worked very hard for it. But over here it is all materialistic. Whatever you have built, here is the house, here is the money, and you are working day and night, working on the pentacles one by one. You have built an empire, or you have built whatever that empire means for you, but you have built materialistic foundations as for now, but you were all alone working for them. Too focused, not bothered about anything, not distracted also by anything. Maybe this is the life which you have led till now, perhaps. Okay, or this is the relationship which you really want, and you've been working hard on this relationship. If it was, pentacles normally mean materialistic thing, but if it is a project or a career sort of a thing, then maybe it can be that situation for some of you. Okay, but to me it looks like whatever the source of happiness is for you, you just need to get set, go with it, because Nine of Emotion, it's a magical time for your life. When wishes are granted, dreams come true. It may seem that good luck is following you, but actually these happy times are just a reward for being a loving and a wonderful person. Your angels are asking you to enjoy your life and have more fun. So this is all about this, Libras. You are showered by this love. Perhaps this is a love of a lifetime, and you have never even witnessed such sort of love, whosoever this person is. Okay, so just be open to this relationship. Just try to understand that this is opening new vistas of happiness to you, or maybe it will bring you a lot of emotional satisfaction, which maybe you were earning for throughout life while you were busy building materialistic foundations. Again, we have the Chariot with the Seven of Spades. So that's what I'm saying. It is a fast-moving energy. You need to act, because I think the balancing part has been done. It is just the get, set, go, ready to go, on the move. You are supposed to be on the move right now, Librans. Number 23 or number 5 may be of some significance for you. Just take a chance on love. Just see the beauty, the way the cards have come out. Take a chance on love. When we love, our lives are changed forever. Just see, this couple is sitting here in the boat, in the turbulent ocean. Here the divine is guiding them and looking. They are just not scared at all. And they are moving. They don't even have the oars of the boat. But they have that love. They have that confidence with each other, the trust with each other, and they are, this trust, this love amongst them is ready to is giving them the energy to face those obstacles or that turbulence of the ocean. And the God is watching them, the divine is watching them, and they will sail through it peacefully. So once we have love, once we love each other, once you have that faith in the universe as to whatever the universe is giving you, you need to trust that, take that chance on love, and you will realize that your lives are changed forever. You will have that happiness forever and ever. Okay, now this forever and ever, I am not saying it is marriage. It may not be marriage, because there is no such card over here, but yes, lover's card is definitely there. So it can be a very good relationship. It can be something which is going to give you a lifetime happiness, a lifetime solace, a lifetime emotional satisfaction, and so many rewards will come to you if you love openly. Okay, the care and appreciation which you have in your heart, okay, which you are longing for, you have to let go of the fear, and you have to give the love you are longing to receive, because if you will not give love, you will not receive love. Okay, so that is also the balance which you need to achieve. You cannot keep on taking. Okay, that was the part which I was saying. Maybe you're trying to balance a relationship. Okay, if you cannot always keep on taking love. You have to give love, to take love, to receive love. Okay, so you need to understand that you cannot always be on the taking side. You have to give love, only then you will be able to receive love. So the love which you are longing for, you will get it only when you let go of the fear of opening up, or not opening up, I should say, of you're not opening up to the person, or you need to open up. You need to open up your emotional boundaries. Only then you will be able to receive the love which your heart is really longing for. Okay, so perhaps your heart is longing for the love which you have not received because you are busy working day and night and building the solid foundations. Librans, it's an awesome, I should say, an awesome reading for you, and a very happy reading for you on this new year, I guess. And I think you should act on it so that you are able to achieve this happiness which you have longed for throughout life, I guess. Okay, Librans, thank you, and I cannot say more about it because I think less means more. Okay, so thank you, and please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.